Hi, everybody. This is just a disclaimer. Wow, guys. This is Phoenix Anka. Is Africa splitting? Is there a part of Africa that's actually splitting? The answer is absolutely yes. In Narok County in Kenya, they have a huge gap. If you look right there on the screen, you'll see it. It is unbelievable how that split is. And it's about 50 feet deep. 50 feet deep. So they got this big old crack here. And apparently it's been getting larger. They say it's going to take 1 million years for the crack to completely go through. But this is actually in Kenya in Narok County. It's a 50 feet hole. And there's a crack in Ethiopia that's 35 miles long. Now, what they're saying is that eventually it's going to split right up in here. All the way from the Ethiopia area all the way down to Tanzania. Now, do you know what's in between this area and this area? Let me tell you what's in between that area. Around 80 volcanoes. Yes, yes, love, you heard me right. Around 80 volcanoes is between Ethiopia and also Tanzania. And that's not even counting the ones that are actually considered extinct. Now let's look at that. Let's look at that. So if I go in right now, look at all these. Oh yeah. Oh yeah. We're talking about it probably splitting around in this area or this area. So around in here, all the way through Ethiopia. And it's supposed to loop through Kenya and go all the way down to Tanzania, which is right down here. So let's look at that big picture there. There's a whole bunch of volcanoes. I counted 70 something and then stopped. I was like at 80, close to 80. And I was like, wow. Now, if you look here, you'll see that there's actually volcanoes that actually erupt that are very active. This volcano up here has been erupting for a while now. Arta-El. It's a shield volcano. It's been erupting for a while now. Then if we go down here, let's see. Let me get this a little smaller. Now, just bear with me. This is a lot of information I'm going to give you today. There are two over here near Rwanda. One is erupting and one is under alert. This one here is erupting. I never could say this right. This is that one that was really, really powerful. Okay? That did a lot of damage. Now, this one here is the other one. This one is under warning right now. It's a shield volcano. Okay? And if we take it down further, even though it's not on the continent, it is a part of Africa. Over here, just want you to see this. This is one of those areas that's getting earthquake swarms, and now this volcano down here is under alert. It's like unrest. In other words, the next stage would be actually erupting. I don't know what happened to those little islands out there, but yeah, this area here is actually the area that would actually split. So it'd be from this area all the way around down here. Somewhere, some sort of curvature right there. Now let's take a look at those pictures. Look at this guy here standing next to that large crack. People just standing there. So this is something that's been going on for a while. Scientists have actually talked about it. I didn't know anything about it. Matter of fact, when I saw it, I was like, what? And the first thing I did was, I gotta research this. Now, it says it's a gigantic crack appears to split Africa in half. It doesn't split the whole thing in half. Leaving a massive 50-foot hole in the ground. Okay, and so this is that article that has this here. I'm going to read a little bit of this to you because you need to know that there's actually a plume that's underneath all of that that's pushing things up from the mantle to further split it. And apparently that is like a rift area, tectonic rift area. It says a massive crack suddenly appeared in Kenya, prompting new discussion of the breakup of Africa into two land masses. The crack continues to grow in size as heavy rainfall in Kenya's Narok County exacerbates the kilometer-sized chasm. The sudden appearance of the crack is related to a regional zone of weakness and broadly associated with the continued breakup of the African continent. The leading hypothesis behind the breakup of the African continent is caused by an underlying superheated plume. This plume is causing Africa to split in two along the eastern edge of the continent. Thankfully, the rifting process will take many millions of years as the crust begins to thin and sink and a small seaway begins to intrude the rift zone. Remember now, there are volcanoes in that area. I don't know what's going to happen with those. That should be very interesting. But I want to read a little bit more of this to you so you can get further understand what's going on out there. A massive crack suddenly appeared in Kenya, prompting new discussion of the breakup of Africa into two land masses. The crack continues to grow in size as heavy rainfall. Okay, we did that part. Splitting a continent in two is quite common. For instance, it led to the opening of the Atlantic Ocean. Notice how Africa and South Africa would fit perfectly together. This is because they were once one landmass. That was Pangaea. Eventually sutured apart by the Mid-Atlantic Ridge. While scientists have known for quite some time about the rifting in Africa, the underlying cause has been, and they lined out hard to pin down. It's been able to be pinned down now. That's why they lined it out. It's the plume. Evidence suggests it is due to the super plume upwelling along the eastern edge of Africa, figuratively burning a hole in the Earth's crust. Wow. This super plume created the East African Rift System, the system associated with the breakup of the African continent. The East African Rift Valley produced as a result of the ongoing splitting of the African continent stretches more than 3,000 kilometers from the Gulf of Aden to Zimbabwe. The Gulf of Aden is way above, that was that water mass that you saw right above Ethiopia. So it's that little bay there. It says the rifting, which began about 25 million years ago, will eventually create two separate continental masses associated with the Somalian and Nubian tectonic plates. So there's two plates there. I only could see the Somalian, but I guess the other one that I saw, they're considering that the Nubian. It didn't say Nubian in Wikipedia. The process, however, will take a million years at the current spreading rate of a few millimeters per year. So this has been going on for a long time. But I want to read this last part to you. While the larger rifting system could be the underlying mechanism for the 50 feet deep and 66 feet wide chasm. So it's 55 feet deep, 66 feet wide. The sudden appearance was likely due to the heavy rainfall in the area exposing the crack. Okay, that's enough of that. It does talk about the wide zone of volcanism and seismic activity uplift and the substance of the ground and the creation of the fissures and the cracks. All of that stuff, all the earthquakes, all the volcanoes, all of that stuff, what they're saying is basically that's what caused all the different cracks for it to get to where it's at right now. Now, there's a little bit more I want to show you about this. Now, a plume, just so you know what a plume is, I have to look up the definition for geology-wise. An upwelling of molten material from the Earth's mantle. So that's coming all the way from the mantle. And down here, they call it a mantle plume. That's pretty much their short definition. Now, I won't read all of this to you. Matter of fact, I'm just letting you know that I'll be putting these links into the description so that way you can take a look at it yourself and further research it. The images are enough to just make you just, your mouth just, your jaw to drop. This is from the Scientific American. This right here would be a good one to look at. You'll see the conflict between the scientists, how one geologist will say this, and they call them also geochemist, and how, you know, another one will say this particular theory. So they're still going around about it as well. Now, this is another article. The African continent is slowly peeling apart. Scientists say a new ocean is being born. So this is another article that you can go through that has some really good information here. It talks about the Arabian plate, the Somalian plate. Those are the two that touch together. And I guess part of it's cracked. So that's the reason why it's just, you know, disintegrating up there. But you can go through this part yourself, you know. So, but just to let you know that when it stated in that article that it was one landmass at one time, they're referring to Pangaea. Pangaea was the one that where everything was all one landmass. This is before we had any continents or anything. That was the continent. There was just one. This is a man that's responsible for coming up with the theory. It was Alfred Wegener. He was the one that came up with the theory that Pangaea actually did really, really did exist at one time. And also he came up with the theory of continental drift as far as how the earth shifts. But this would be a good article. I'll have this also in the description for you. This is one of the best analogies I've seen as far as how the earth has shaped itself into what it is now. It shows you in the very, very top, Pangaea. Then later on, it moved to this one here. Then it moved to this one here. Then it moved to this one here where everything split. And this is where we are today. You know, a lot of people say this is you can actually look at it. But one thing that one of these articles I ran across, and it gave me this link, it stated how the size of Africa, with its 54 countries in it, is misconstrued as far as the actual size. It says, what do you think, this person's map? It said, did you know that Africa's size was misrepresented? Yes, it is. I can't remember the name of that other map that showed the real true size of Africa. It is huge. But if you look at this here, you'll see that Spain could fit in it, France, Germany, Portugal, United States, Eastern Europe, Italy, Switzerland, India, all of India, all of China. It says part one and part two of China, Japan, and the UK could fit in that little bitty island that we were looking at. One of those little islands on the side. I think it's Madagascar. So, I mean, all these places, you know, it's really funny. Everybody downs this place, but they all try to rob it. Just about everybody that can fit in there can't been doing that. It's amazing. So Africa is a large continent. Huge, absolutely huge. It's the largest one we have. And you know, it's so funny when it comes to things. I ran across this page and I died laughing. It said 1% control the world, 4% are their puppets, 90% are asleep, 5% know and try to wake up the 90%. The 1% use the 4% to prevent the 5% from waking up the 90%. I was like, spot on. And I'm going to make sure this link is there so you can get a good laugh out of it. This right here was talking about some of the plumes around the world. And yes, Yellowstone is one of them. Yellowstone is right there. And you'll see Hawaii is bright red. And, you know, they have all these different ones. So they've identified, they know where all these trouble spots are. Okay. And this is here. This is another article that we'll put in here for you. What made the ground split open in Kenya? And it goes into detail and it talks about the different rifts, the African rift, as far as this, what's in the land that's causing all these problems. So I'll make sure all these are in there for you. But just remember that Africa is definitely splitting. It's not happening tomorrow, but it is something that a lot of times people don't know about it, that even live there. I mean, not live in that area, but live in that that particular continent. Not everybody in the continent knows that that's happening. Just like I lived in California, I didn't know Clear Lake was a volcano. We used to go fishing there all the time when I was a little kid. And I didn't know Mount Tamalpais in the Bay Area was a volcano. Nobody never told us that as kids or growing up or in school. And, you know, just keep in mind, when you go to a state or national park, make sure you look up that state park or national park and make sure it's not a volcano. Because there's actually a program of Volcano State and National Park Association type of group that actually manages those, that oversees those. So you guys, just be safe. Make sure you're aware of your surroundings. Research where you live. There might be something right there and you have no ideas there. But make sure you stay safe. Like, share, and subscribe. And we will see you in the next video. Take care. Ciao.